Nadja Salerno-Sonnenberg. I am now a professor of music at Loyola University in New Orleans, a former soloist and record and former a lot of things. I was born in Rome, Italy. Somebody asked me, oh, I remember who did this. Johnny Carson asked me, what were you doing there? And I said, my mom was there. I was like, what kind of question is that? You know what's funny? The kind of music that I heard when I was little, when I was in Italy, I heard a lot of opera, and that's it. And I do remember very vividly seeing Aida at a place called Caracalla. And it's right outside of Rome. It's an outdoor, ancient, of course, everything is ancient there, amphitheater. And it's huge, and it's phenomenal. And what I remember of this production of Aida was the elephants, real elephants, pooping. That's my memory. That's my first operatic memory. So my very early introduction to opera came from my grandfather, John Salerno. We called him Papa John. Giovanni Battista Salerno. I was so fortunate because my grandfather had this knowledge of opera and love of opera. The first time I heard jazz was when I came here to this country. I was 8 and older. I absolutely see not only a relationship, but a marriage between coloratura opera singing and female scat singing. You know, listening to Joan Sutherland and Ella Fitzgerald, just about the same thing, you know, in the most opposite ways. But it's extraordinary. Joan Sutherland was regarded as, you know, the greatest soprano slash coloratura of her time. Well, she was of her time, there's no doubt. If you ever heard her sing Traviata, which is not really a bel canto, but, you know, the famous aria, Sempre Libera, her version is, I mean, it just knocks you off. You gotta laugh. It's stunning, stunning. I mean, she's got these, she sings as if she's playing the piano. I mean, it's almost as if you're listening to, you know, Oscar Peterson. Classical and jazz, and not really much else, requires extraordinary discipline. These two art forms need to be a practice. You need to practice to be good or great at these two art forms. Get that lick right. Get that lick right. Play that run correctly. Get that shift, that jump. Whatever you're doing, you have to practice to be really good as a jazz musician or as a classical musician. If I had the choice of being a violinist or an opera singer, without a doubt, opera singer. I mean, there's nothing to think about. Boy, if I could play Tosca, yeah. Tosca. You know, Tosca is pretty much Scarlett O'Hara. You know, so these are great roles. I mean, that's a great role. Butterfly is a phenomenal role. Nothing that I can relate to, but my God, what a role. I mean, it just goes, Carmen is great. I mean, everybody thinks Carmen is all about sex and sexual freedom. She just was about freedom. Just don't tie me down, you know, that's, but Tosca was the role that I related to the most, and I'm not even quite sure why, except that she was very strong, very alpha lady, and that I can understand that. Yeah, that would be it for me, Tosca. If I just had one crack at it, that would be it.